The first modification that we'll make is to the shaft. So we're going to double click on it right in the assembly document so we can edit it locally. Next, we'll point out that this is an imported model, meaning that there's no history. From here, we'll go to the shape icon bar and go to face modification. We're going to set a direction, and now we're just going to window select the faces that we want to modify. In here, you see a dynamic preview of those faces being modified. We'll give it the value that we want to apply, and like that, TopSolid 7 does all the hard work for us. We also want to point out that this is adding history, so if we go and right-click and edit on that history tree, we can add or edit this feature. We've added the face and thus shifted the slot with this design change. Now we're done making a change to that model. Next, we'll double-click on the case to modify that. And again, this is imported dumb data. In this case, we're going to try and modify the diameter of the four drillings. So we'll select all four of them. Then we can just double click on the balloon that was created by the software, modify its value, and validate. Like that, we've modified the four drillings and history has been added to the tree. Next, we'll do a little bit more challenging change. So we're going to use FreeShape design. And we're going to start by recognizing fillets on the model. So here we'll select all the fillets in the area that we want to work on. Like that, TopSolid 7 is going to extract them, but add them to our history tree as a fillet feature. Next, we're going to select a couple faces and unfix them. When we unfix them, they're going to become purple. So next, we'll have to constrain them, which we can ask the software to do automatically for us. Finally, we're going to go ahead and add some driving dimensions to these three-dimensional faces. And yes, they're driving dimensions. This means that we'll be able to modify them and thus modify the 3D dumb data. So here we'll add this last dimension. And now let's make some design changes. Let's maybe modify the 20 millimeter value to 25. And like that, the geometry updates. How about the 7.5 millimeter to 5? And now let's exit out of FreeShape and watch what happens. All of the fillets that we stripped out have been reapplied, but reapplied as a TopSolid 7 feature. So now we can even modify those and change those. And like that, our in-place edit is complete, and our design changes are finished.